before I started, so I'm not avoiding people shaking hands. I actually got hurt the other day. I keep forgetting, and people remind me as they squeeze my hand. It actually hurts. And also, before I begin, I just want to thank everyone for inviting me today, particularly Elaine, who's been kind of the key point, the key person here. And most importantly, I want to say thank you for lunch, because it looks like you guys get food and we don't get food back up in the VR. Money. Something we often want more of, and something we often don't really discuss. So I'm a wealth coach, and I sit with dozens of people each year, and we discuss their personal finances. I've sat with the person who's straight out of college, I've sat with the big-time CEO, and I've found that regardless of income, the same principal issues exist. Within the next 5 minutes, you guys are going to learn some of the most important keys to building your wealth. Whether you're just beginning your career or you've transitioned often, week one on the job kind of goes the same. You're filled with excitement and uncertainty. You're really excited to work, even though you have no idea what you're going to be doing. You're hoping that you're going to make more than you previously did, and you're ready to work hard. You walk around, you're meeting new people, trying to remember their names and the roles that they fill. One of these people that you meet is going to explain your benefit packages. That's going to be your health insurance, your retirement plans, and whatever perks you get from your job. You don't even understand what the person's explaining to you, but they make you sign 100 pages, check off a few boxes, and you don't really care because you just want to get that out of the way and start working. Soon you're in your own routine, and often you're not going to revisit any of those papers that you signed, ever, but probably for a few years at least. Does that sound familiar to anybody?
Yes. Yeah.
The longer we live, the faster time flies. For some, it's only been months since that first week on the job. For others, it's been decades. In that time, you've come across a bunch of financial information. Now, you may have a friend or relative in the financial space. You may have a person who comes to the office once a year. You may have been waiting online to get coffee, and that person gave you financial advice. We also, of course, we have media sources, right? So we have TV, newspapers, magazines. They just bombard us with financial information, and it's confusing, right? Because what you read in one magazine is total counterintuitive to what you've seen on Google. Have you ever sat down and actually discussed your personal finances? Not even with a professional, but for those who are married, maybe with your spouse, for those who have significant others, perhaps with that person. A lot of people haven't, which is mind-boggling. Now, some of you guys are sitting here, well, I signed up, I have my 401k, that's established. Okay, great. Does that mean your whole financial future is totally set? Even if you examine the 401k briefly, a lot can happen between now and retirement, which is when that is for, right? The money's going to be locked up till you reach retirement. Heck, we might not make it to retirement. We don't know what's going to happen. One day, voluntarily or involuntarily, we're all going to be out of the workforce. Do we agree with that?
Yes.
And how we prepare financially is going to dictate how we're able to live then. Just like your income drives your lifestyle today, what you've built up in the future is going to drive your lifestyle then. Now, you've probably heard stories of people making money in the markets, right? They made really good investments. And if you had some extra money, maybe you would make some investments too. Compared to the dozens of people that you know, or the hundreds of people that you know, how many people do you really know that made a lot of money in the market? You know a lot? Probably not. Not personally. You may have heard the stories, but probably not personally. And the reality is most wealthy people didn't just get lucky in the market. Did you ever think about how mom and dad or grandma and grandpa were able to pay off their mortgage and their debts, and they did it on less income and less investment choices? How'd they do it? Well, I found that wealthy people practiced two ancient strategies that most of us in America have forgotten about. I'm going to give you four fundamental words that are literally worth millions of dollars to you. Ready for them? Work hard, save money. Think about that for a second. Work hard, we can't use this hand, save money. Okay? Who actually does that anymore? Right? We have a variety of ages. Think about that. Who actually does that anymore today? We want to work the least and get the most. Right? People don't want to work anymore. Now, some of you are sitting back saying, of course saving money is the answer. But I got bills. I got rent. I got mortgage. Some people have kids. Apparently those cost a lot. And if I just made a little more money, it would be easier. Reality check. Maybe it would be easier, and likely it wouldn't. Okay? Because expenses always rise to meet what your income level is. We spend more time planning our vacations than we do our personal finances. I see some heads nodding. I see some elbow poking too. The reality is that we all know we're supposed to save money, but we're so busy with life, especially in New York, that we're running around constantly, and we actually forget to do it. Like, oh, I forgot to save money this month. I'll just do it next month. Been there, right? So most people go about saving in a particular manner, and what they do is they pay all their bills, and then they hope that there's some money left over for savings. And oftentimes they find that there's not much there. The way we coach our clients is to go in an opposite direction, actually, which is where we set up, we teach them a principle called pay yourself first. And so what that is making sure that in the beginning of the month versus the end of the month, that you put money away for yourself first, then you pay all your bills, okay? And with responsible people, you will pay your bills. But I often ask, who's more important, Verizon or you? See, we're so apt to pay Verizon or MasterCard or you name whatever bill it is, and we forget about taking care of ourselves. And whose responsibility is that? No one's going to do it for you. It's a habit that should be created. And the earlier you create habits, the better off you'll be. Well, if they're good habits. Okay? You build a habit of not saving, when you get increased income, you probably still won't save. If you build a habit of saving early, you probably have that habit as income goes up. We target our clients to help them save between 15 and 20% of their gross income. So what does that mean? Someone who makes $100,000, they should be saving about 20 grand a year. Okay? Now some of you are saying, holy crap, I cannot do that. It's normally not done overnight. Okay? But you have to understand the reason and rationale behind that recommendation. You see, we're all faced with financial threats. Okay? It doesn't matter who you are, doesn't matter how much money you're making, we're all faced with financial threats. Things like taxes take away from the money that we're making. Things like inflation, purchasing power, that takes away from the money you're making. We all have various expenses that takes away from the money you're making. Some people get hurt and they can't work. That's going to put a dent in your plans, right? So there's a ton, I can list a ton of them. And if we're not battling against them, eventually they're going to overcome us. So saving money ends up being important regardless. I talk to people how one of the threats is technological change, right? So he's holding an iPad over there. Everyone has a smartphone. These didn't exist a decade ago, but now they're necessity. Right? So I tell people, luxuries become necessities, don't they? And there's things that aren't created today that we're going to have to buy in the future. Doesn't that cost money? Where are you going to get it from? We've got to save for it. I know it sounds really simple. because we all know that we should save money. But the evidence points to that's not that easy, right? Because if it was, then everyone would be walking around. Well, they are walking around spending money. They don't have it. I'm going to encourage you today to start building a routine savings habit. Okay? If you, it's like working out. If you build the muscle early, you're going to be really strong in it later on in life. It's going to be hard at first because it's an adjustment and it's different and you're not used to doing it. But as you progress, as you strengthen that, you're going to be really happy when you're looking back. Four fundamental words. Work hard, save money. Thank you.